Tejeda's woman is outraged. She says Quest is putting her family in danger.
She isn't getting any phone service. Action 7 News reporter Alana Gold is here now to explain why she's so frustrated.
Shelley and Doug, this homeowner tells us the phone service has been a problem for several years because she lives in such an isolated area, but claims in the last week it's been worse than ever. She says she keeps contacting Quest to fix the problem, but she's getting nowhere.
No dial tone. Dead. No service.
Lisa Perea says she's tired of having no dial tone at her Tejeda's home.
This is just completely unacceptable.
And in this remote area, a landline is something she desperately needs.
I can't call 911. I can't get help if there's an emergency, a medical emergency, a fire. I have nothing.
Perea can't use her cell phone here either because this area is too isolated to get reception. So she has to drive 5 miles into town just to make a phone call.
I don't even know that frustrating is a strong enough word. It's infuriating.
After contacting Quest almost a dozen times during this past week, Perea says a crew showed up a few days ago and made matters worse.
Draped this temporary wire, attached it here, draped it through the trees. It's running all along the ground, all the way down the road.
Perea tells us this supposed fix did nothing, and the telephone wire strung above her driveway is too low to the ground.
It prevents my propane company from delivering me fuel, which I depend on for heat.
Now this homeowner is demanding Quest clean up the mess.
It's worse than the Beverly Hillbillies. It's a joke.
And get her a working landline.
Do your job. Fix the problem.
We talked to Quest about this problem, and a spokesperson told us the company is coming up with a permanent solution to get Perea's phone service restored and says workers will be at her home tomorrow morning to fix everything. Shelley, back to you.
And that spokesperson told us Quest will credit her phone bill for the time her service wasn't working.